Did it work? That's the biggest question. Did we get this fixed? Do have me get fucked. Do have me get fucked. Do have me get fucked. Yay! Is it any better is my biggest question. So far it's saying I have zero drop frames, so that's a lot better. Is it running smooth on y'all's end? That's my biggest thing I need to know. Oh, no. Sailor Jeff, I was having dropped frames through the roof, too. So that's the only reason I restarted OBS. Is it had me at like 20% dropped frames. And I haven't had that in a very long time. Hey, Enritz, this isn't rock. Not that I'm complaining, I'm just pointing out a fact. So we're back to getting the bass down for the German half track. Now we're going to hit the underside. Oh, getting closer and closer to being done with the black gray. This is a, it's from Bolt Action, which is a World War II based tabletop game. So, it's part of Wargaming, but you, it's a collectible as well. I just really like painting it, painting Bolt Action figures and everything. I've been trying to keep it an average of one, at least one stream of Bolt Action every week. Think I've been doing pretty decent at keeping that. But it's a really fun war game as well. You can pick up, there's a great site for you to go if you're interested for picking up Bolt Action figures, and it's one of my sponsors, Wartime Hobbies. So if you go to the info section below my stream and you scroll to the very bottom, you will see a sponsors section. Wartime Hobbies is the sponsor that I'm talking about. All you do is click on their logo and it'll take you straight to their website. They have loads of Bolt Action stuff for you to choose from. And then if you go to Secret Weapons Miniatures, my other sponsor, I just thought of this, I don't know why it just now clicked, but they've got in their one of their specialty things, they've got spent shell casings you can purchase. You can utilize those as they make really good tokens that mark if you've been pinned or things along those lines for the game. The auto hosts, thank you everyone who's got me to be hosted. It means a lot to me. The support is awesome. Just saying. Hey, Wi-Fire, how you doing, bro? Caught your stream the other day, and I was thoroughly enjoying it. nearly done building all the towel stuff. You've been at that for a good minute. Let's get caught up on the chat real quick because lots going on. Doing great, Joe. Went and taught a client's son painting a Necron, so that was fun. Didn't get any of the stuff. stuff I wanted to paint done. So that's what the stream's for, right? Get the painting I want to paint done. Enrich, I did see the photos. Unless you're asking somebody else. Oh yeah, I know. I gotta give myself some time and everything. But today was, normally I do. Today was one of those days where I spent more time teaching than I anticipated. But it's okay, it's not that big of a deal this time around. Because the way I see it is, as long as my client's happy, then that's what actually is more important at the moment. Think about how I felt after the 25-hour stream. Cool. I might go, not for the class. I plan on going to hang out. And to take my daughter there. Because she's wanting to see everybody and she wants to play games and stuff like that. So, my plan is to go to hang out for a little bit.
Take it. Cause pain in my name.
Particle Vagrant, thank you for the follow. I wouldn't be able to do what I do if it wasn't for all of you, so thank you very much. I'm glad you enjoyed the stream enough to give it a follow. Hope to see more of you in the future. But yeah, FC Chuck, I'll be up at the LGS Saturday to hang out. And I'll be sure to bring your Oh man, I'll tell you what, my back was screaming at me after the 25-hour stream when I woke up the next morning. But I told myself every last bit of it was worth it. And would I do it again? Hell yeah, I would. Another Star Set, Madonna. We'll see. Warhammer 40k, but I got bored because it felt like same thing over and over. Don't like future stuff, but that's all that was there. Age of Sigmar. Yeah, so I'm gonna be honest with you, it's a real simple game. It's as far as putting an army together, it's very simple. You can download what's the program I use? I use Has 047. Thank you for the follow. It means the world to me. I wouldn't be able to do what I do if it wasn't for all of you. So I'm glad you enjoy the stream enough to give me a follow, and I hope to see more of you in the future. Version 2 is very simplified. It answers a lot of the questions that version 1 had. Movement simplified. The just everything about it's been simplified, so beginners can easily pick up how to play. Not a whole bunch of complicated rules. It's not expensive to get into, and it's just a whole lot of fun chaos. So I highly, highly recommend that you play. There's going to be some points where you have to refer to the rule book. But you don't need to leave the rule, like, literally, this was, like, say this is the rule book. I'm like, okay, set it down to the side. This guy's going to move here, and he's going to fire at that unit over there. So, the type of gun he uses requires 3d6s. Since he's German, he's got the Hitler's buzzsaw attribute, so throw in an extra D6. Alright, your unit's in hardcover, so it'll originally hits on 5s, now it hit on 4s. They are pinned already. So hit on 5s again. Okay. Roll the dice. Oh, look. I got 2 hits. I mean, it's that simple. I haven't gotten to play it a lot recently because I'm always busy, but I love the game. So now we're going to go Vallejo game color black, and we're going to hit the tires. We're gonna hit the wheels with black. That's one of the sets. That is the Band of Brothers set. It comes with the American Airborne Infantry and German Someone put Babylon by Head PE on the queue, please. Those of you new to the channel, by the way, if you are working on anything and you want to be able to share it with the chat and everything, all you have to do is post a link to the picture of your project and be happy to share it. Yeah, I like seeing what my viewers are working on, so feel free to post the link. I really need to put my Sherman together at some point. swallow, and I appreciate that you enjoyed the stream enough to give me a follow, so I hope to see more of you in the future. Stumbling on my words now. But yeah, so out of all your all the new those just tuning in, how's your evening going? Hope everything's going good for y'all.
Weapon of extreme feebleness and maniacal cruelty. Take it, cause pain in my name.
Rogue428, thank you for the follow. Wouldn't be able to do what I do if it wasn't for all of you, so thank you for the follow. I'm glad you enjoy the stream enough to give a follow. Hope to see more of you in the future. So for those of you just tuning in, I'm working on Bolt Action, a German half track from the game Bolt Action. It's a World War II based tabletop game. It's a lot of fun. If you go to my info section and you scroll all the way to the bottom, Rogue428, thank you for the host. But you go to my sponsor section, you'll see Wartime Games. Give it, click on their logo and it'll take you to their site, and they actually have a whole slew of Bolt Action things you can check out and just give a look-see to see if it's something that would interest you. But this is a fun game. It's simple. It's very simple. Not so many rules that you get confused real easily. I mean, it's just more fun than anything I've ever had. Plus, you get an opportunity to reenact some of the old World War II scenarios and everything, like Operation Market Garden and D-Day. I mean, you can reenact any of the major battles that happened during World War II. You can definitely reenact on the tabletop, which is something I love about the. But yeah, so I'm going over also for those of you just tuning in right now, I'm hitting the tracks with Runefang Silver from Citadel, just a base coat. We're eventually gonna go over it with Rust from Secret Weapon Miniatures. I love Oh, Darkness, I am doing awesome. I'm having a blast. I'm painting, which is one of my favorite things to do in the entire world, is paint. Hanging out with all of you is the second most favorite thing to do. Literally, I look forward, every day I look forward to when I'm on stream and hanging out with all of y'all. And, no, I'm not going off of any particular World War II paint guide for this. I used to live in Germany and Europe, and I'm basing a lot of the colors off of what I personally saw in person when I went to World War II museums. Wishing you could eat all the cookies. I want cookies. Yes, I based everything with a brush. Yep, I went over all the base coats are done with a brush. I did not set up my airbrush in time for the stream. So I was like, you know what? I enjoy hand painting anyways. So I brushed it all. And I know I'm not going to finish the vehicle in one stream, seeing as I'm on till midnight Eastern, but we will be working on this more, so this will not be the last time you see this vehicle, because Aaron's would have my hide anyways if I didn't finish it on stream. Seeing as I already drive them crazy with my palette anyway. Hand and used as a cloak. You'll hear me say it all the time. Secret Weapon Miniatures, they provide a awesome rust line. Along with the pigments. which I'll be using Red Rust Pigment. Now we're going to utilize the rust, and we're going to go over the tracks. I'm looking at you. Look like how it looked after during World War II, because of all the moisture and everything. And you only need to put a thin amount on it, really. Just a thin layer. And it gives it the used look. And then it'll look like actual tracks other than in here. In here, I'm going to hit them with, I'm going to hit it with a light gray on the actual tracks themselves. You got to think also, though, this is in the middle of the war. Then they didn't really do the spray paint back then either. Hey, Maddie, how you doing? That noise when you vacuum up a bit. Ooh. What issue did you have with your Gilball model? Oh no! It sucks, don't. So this isn't for the actual rust. It's just the color of the track to give it coloration, by the way. Just like I'm gonna use... That's not it. Once I get everything done, I want to get my Sterling mud. I can't find it right now. And I'm actually going to put Sterling mud along the bottom. And have it like mud's been kicked up. Put some Sterling mud along here on the edges. Right here on the axle. So I'm gonna add that stuff to it as well. You lost Gutter's arm? Oh. So, where is it? Now we're gonna utilize Vallejo model color, London Gray. But, yeah. Where am I? And I've done this whole thing with the one brush. So, now we're just gonna go over. Where do I wanna start? The biggest question. I'm not going to paint all the way to the edge. I'm going to leave some there because it adds for shadow. But now we're going to go over with one in gray. Thank you. All right, darkness. What are you talking about? What are you talking about, Enritz? No, I think about it, I've used a lot of gray lately. You're right, I've used a lot of grays lately. I'll admit, I've been using a lot of gray lately. But the Germans, their vehicles, the mass majority of their vehicles were gray. I'm gonna finish this hood right here, and then I'll get caught up on the chat, so bear with me. Like I said, I'm not going all the way to the edges. I'm going to leave the cracks and crevices the dark gray, the black gray, because it creates the shadow, which is something I'm looking for. Without the shadow, it doesn't look quite as realistic as it could. All right, let's get caught up on the chat. Just stealthily choosing models that need gray. That could be a possibility. That could be a very high possibility. Or maybe, just maybe, I mean, this might sound crazy, but just maybe it's a coincidence. What about them apples? But, I mean, it also makes real great collectibles. And this happens to be a German World War II German half track. I've been wanting to paint it for some time now, and I finally got around to it. You don't care for the models? Gotcha. Well, I'm sorry you feel that way. I've been having a blast painting this one, though. And Darkness is back. Good to see you back. Got you, Enritz. Take your time. Seems like Warhammer 40K without all the special rules for every chapter and whatnot. Are you talking about Conflict 47 or are you talking about Bolt Action? Thank you. But, anyways, we're going with the second layer for, the half track. London Grey. Which is closer to the actual color we want the half track to be. And as you can tell, by not going all the way over to the cracks and crevices, it creates that shadow effect. And that's what we're looking for when we do this. The darkness and the cracks and crevices, it's like you're giving life to the inanimate object that you're painting. And it looks really nice. And now we're gonna do the little shield right here. Once I get this gun painted, I'll jump back over to the chat. Try to get caught up. Darkness, you take it easy. Thank you for coming out and spending time with me. I mean, it's been a blast. I'm actually gonna be calling it a little bit early tonight solely because my back is killing me. I thought I'd be able to just power through it, but not tonight. So I apologize, everyone. I don't normally do this, but tonight I'm going to have to cut it because my back just is really hurting. So when we go in, be sure to give Wi-Fi some love. And again, I apologize, everyone, but it hurts. I'm hurting bad. But that's as far as we got with her with this tonight, which really isn't that bad. A lot farther than I expected. For those of you who are new to the channel, please give me a follow if you enjoy it. Tomorrow will be a better stream, I promise. As we work on Marvel Universe's Colossus. And then we'll probably jump back to this guy if we finish Colossus in time. I'm going to try to work on Crusher from Super Dungeon Explorer. To try to finish him. But those of you new to the channel, also go to the info section. You'll find links to my Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube. Give them likes, subscribes, and follows as you see fit. For YouTube and Twitch, you'll get all my videos, of course. YouTube, you get special access to the Skull Collection, which is my broadcast that talks about what's happened over the last week and what's to come over the next week. So it gives you a little heads up of what's going on. The only place you have access to that is in the YouTube. Twitter and Facebook is what I utilize to keep y'all informed what's all going on with myself, Chinkuza. Facebook and Instagram I utilize as my portfolios. So please go ahead, give those likes, subscribes, and follows as you see fit. Everyone who followed me tonight, thank you very, very, very much. It means a lot to me. Like I said before, I wouldn't be able to do what I do if it wasn't for all of you. So it does, from the bottom of my heart, thank you. Lady Draco Miniatures, thank you for the follow. I wouldn't be able to do what I do if it wasn't for all of you, so thank you very much. I'm glad you enjoyed the stream enough to give me a follow. Hope to see more of you in the future. But yeah, we're going to throw Wi-Fi a host. So Y'all have a good night, and make sure you show them some love.